On behalf of Aircruise Aviation Private Limited, I welcome you all in today's webinar. So today's topic is very interesting because today we'll come to know that how you can become an airline pilot in Gulf. So let's start our webinar and see what are the steps and what are the criteria to become an airline pilot in Gulf. Now, there are a few points which you have to keep in mind before entering any flight school. First is research. Research what kind of pilot you want to be and the pilot license required. It is very important to do your thorough research before entering into any flight school. Know the basic requirements. It's very important to know where you would like to start from. So to become an airline pilot in Gulf, there are certain entry requirements. See whether you fulfill them or not. So these are, you have to be at least 17 years old. You should be able to read, speak, write, and understand the English language. And also pass doctor examination for commercial pilot license at least 18 years old and high school graduates. So these are the basic requirements which you need to know before enrolling or choosing yourself as a pilot. Now, let me tell you step-by-step guide on how you can become a pilot in Gulf. So as I already shared, the first and the very basic step is research. Research the different options you have to become an airline pilot in Gulf. Start off by researching online through Google, YouTube, Facebook pilot group, and others. The more you research you do initially, the more you will come to know about the options and the process of how to become a pilot in Gulf. There are different pilot training options. There are different flight schools. There are different aviation related colleges, degree program, and airline cadet pilot program. So choose accordingly. Now, the second basic step is about the requirements. Age. The minimum age to start your pilot training is 17 years old. Then you receive a student pilot license and a retirement age for airline pilots actively flying is 67 years old. Very important step is the medical certificates. In order to start your pilot training, you need to secure a medical certificate. In order to get this, it is best to speak with the flight school you want to start with, and they will help arrange it for you. Now, let us talk about the educational requirement. It is very important and essential to note at this point that you can get a student pilot license, private pilot license, and commercial pilot license with a high school degree. English proficiency is must. The language of aviation internationally is English, and it is recommended to meet a level 4 English standard before receiving your commercial pilot license. Now, before or while joining a flight school, what are the things you need to keep in mind? Training stages. Now, let us talk about the training stages. Step 3 is training stages. Now let us talk about the student pilot license. So a student pilot license allows you to start your flight training. Private pilot license, this license will allow you to fly solo or fly passengers or cargo, but without receiving any money for it. Now let us talk about the most important license, and that is the commercial pilot license. This license will allow you to earn from flying and be a paid professional pilot. Instrument rating. Being instrument rated means that you can fly the aircraft in any weather condition using just the instruments. Multi-engine rating. License which allows you to fly multi-engine craft. Now, let us find out what you need to do after getting a pilot license. Check out the careers you can pursue. Step 4 are the career options. Airline pilot for the large airlines or smaller regions. Corporate or business aviation pilot, cargo pilot, charter flight instructor, medical or air ambulance pilots. So these are the career options you can choose from. Exciting and very interesting to know that This degree or this license can give you, or you can earn up to 29,400 AED per month. Now, let me tell you a few tips which will help you out to choose the right kind of flight school for yourself. Determine your pilot goal. Decide on your long-term aspirations in aviation. Ask yourself if you want to become a pilot in your free time or join an airline. Consider your budget. This is very essential as your budget will play a big role in choosing a flight school. Since different schools have different costs due to location, number of students, aircraft type, etc., you need to find out what drives the cost difference and look for a flight school that would cater to your reference. Very important, know your preferred duration. Flight schools have different training durations and schedules. Some schedules are more flexible than the others. So look for a flight school that works best for your time. Visit your shortlist of flight school. It would be great if you can find the time to speak to the instructors and management teams to learn more about trainings, safety practices, history, and graduates of flight school. So it is an essential step to visit your shortlist of flight schools. Now, are you ready to take off? Done. Yeah.